Good morning everyone. The class is about sequel of pulpitis. Any word having the suffix itis means inflammation. So pulpitis means inflammation of the pulp. There are various etiological factors for the pulpitis to occur, like presence of the dental caries or any fracture of the tooth, or while doing cavity preparation, the accidental exposure of the pulp causes the pulpitis, attrition, abrasion, and the presence of dissimilar restorations may cause galvanism that eventually lead to pulpitis. So this pulpitis is of two types, reversible pulpitis and irreversible pulpitis. In case of the reversible pulpitis, when there is a mild to moderate inflammation of the pulp on removal of the stimulus, which means stimulus here means dental caries. So on removal of the decayed part of the tooth and restoring it will lead to normal conditioning of the pulp. Associated symptoms of the reversible pulpitis are, there may be mild to moderate, non-spontaneous, non-radiating sharp pain, and on taking cold or sweet foods, the pain may get aggravated, and the pain gets relieved by itself after removal of the stimulus, which means by restoring it. And in this case, the tendon percussion is absent, and the treatment here is restoration of the decayed portion of the teeth. So next is the irreversible pulpitis. In case of irreversible pulpitis, there are two types, acute and chronic. In case of acute irreversible pulpitis, even after the removal of the stimulus, the mild to moderate inflammation of the pulp doesn't come into normal condition of the pulp. And the associated symptoms for this are, there may be moderate to severe sharp type of pain, or there may be throbbing type of pain, and this pain can be intermittent, which means it can occur at some time of the day and again it disappears, or it may be continuous, which means the pain may be present throughout the day. And in this case, on taking of cold or hot foods, the pain may get aggravated, and this kind of pain is not relieved by itself, and tendon percussion is absent, and the treatment includes the endodontic treatment of the tooth. Next is the chronic irreversible pulpitis. Acute inflammatory cells are replaced by the chronic inflammatory cells, and the patient may complain of decayed teeth, which is usually painless, and even in this case the tendon percussion is absent. Those tooth which can be saved are treated by the root canal treatment, and those tooth which are grossly decayed and cannot be saved or treated by extraction. Next is the chronic hyperplastic pulpitis. This is also called pulp polyp. In this case, you can observe a decayed teeth along with a cauliflower like growth of the pulp. In the picture, we can observe there is a mass that is arising from the pulp. And this is painless, and on trying to cutting it, it gets profusely bleed. And this pulp polyp has to be differentiated from proliferating gingival tissue. This can be done by using a probe or excavator. When we are trying to lift the mass, we can differentiate it whether it is arising from the gingiva or it is arising from the pulp. Coming to acute apical periodontitis, painful inflammation of periodontium as a result of trauma, irritation or infection through root canal, regardless of whether the pulp is vital or non-vital. And in this case, we can observe the symptoms of pulpitis or necrosis along with pain on biting. And here in acute apical periodontitis, if we try to percuss the teeth, the patient feels pain, and on taking radiograph, there will be widening of the periodontal ligament space. Here you can observe there is a slight widening at the apex of the roots. Here the treatment includes endodontic treatment, and to control the post-operative pain, analgesics we should prescribe analgesics to patients. Apical periodontitis can progress into periapical granuloma or periapical abscess. First, we'll see about periapical granuloma. So, periapical granuloma is a granulation tissue formation around the apex of root in response to low-grade chronic inflammation. And this can be asymptomatic or slightly discomfort to the patient. On clinical examination, there may be little or no pain on percussion. On radiograph, there will be interruption to the lamina dura at the apical area, and there will be periapical radiolucency that is less than 1.6 centimeters. Here you can observe in the picture there is a periapical radiolucency at the apex of the premolar teeth, and the treatment here includes the root canal.